Alright, folks, today we are grilling stuffed pumpkins, so stay tuned. It's time to grill! And again, I'm able to record a video I have on my bucket list for a long, long time. Let's get started with chopping up an onion, medium-sized onion, just into rings. Then start your grill, in this case my max zone, infrared grilling zone, followed by my favorite cast iron pan, and then place in the onions and add some oil. I decided to take some chili flavored oil, but you can use any olive oil or butter that you like. These onions will be cooked for approximately 10 till 15 minutes and they will be part of our stuffing. And I really, really like to use onions inside stuffing for my pumpkin. If you want to recreate this dish at home, make sure to check out the video description. We will have the complete list of ingredients in there. Make sure not to cook them too dark. Once they are ready, take them off the cast iron pan and let them cool down a little bit. In the meantime, you can take a larger bowl with ground beef and barbecue rub, followed by the onions and some diced cheese. I like to have the cheese inside the meat. So give it a good mix and take your pumpkin. This is a Japanese pumpkin that is called in Germany Hokkaido pumpkin. And I think it's the pumpkin that is used most in Germany for cooking. I guess there are two reasons for that. First of all, it tastes good. Second one is preparation is rather simple. Only take out the seeds, cook it, and you're ready to eat it. Once we have everything out of the pumpkin, we have enough space for the ground beef, cheese, onion, barbecue rub mixture. And just stuff it in there gently. Make sure it gets everywhere. And we are doing a great job today with the amount, the 300 grams of ground beef, the cheese and the onions is just enough for that size of my pumpkin. Now add the lid, it looks better again, and throw it on your grill. You can smoke it. I used my gas grill today again. We have the left and the right burners on. The cooking temperature is 160 degrees Celsius, which is approximately 320 degrees Fahrenheit, and we're cooking it to the internal temperature of the ground beef. This ground beef is freshly grounded the day I recorded the video, so for me it's okay to grill it and it's still pink inside. So we are headed for an internal temperature of 58 till 60 degrees Celsius, and this is approximately 136 degrees Fahrenheit, or something about 140. I think you get the point. If the meat is fresh enough, you can eat it raw anyway, without any problems, no matter what USDA says. There you go. Look how juicy that is. After 1 hour of cooking, this is the result. And I love how juicy that is. Oozing cheese and the combination of that pumpkin flavor with ground beef, barbecue rub and cheese is just awesome. I'm really excited what you think about that dish. Leave me a comment, hit that like button, subscribe if you haven't subscribed yet. Make sure to visit my fan pages, I'm everywhere. You can check out my Facebook, my Instagram, my Patreon. I'm even on TikTok, new stuff there. Anyway, thanks for watching, I'm out, see you.